Dear ladies and gentlemen, today I have the honor to represent our amazing speaker, our Basha, one of the most charismatic, effective, efficient, I don't know. And today she will deliver the speech, which will, I am sure, entertain us and will make our moods on a higher level. So without, I know that you expect her instead of my talking, so let's welcome, here we go, our Basha! I told ya!
But the first thing is, I have to check out whether I'm in a good place. So tell me, darling, is it Tri-City Toastmaster
Club? Yes, it is.
Yeah, English speaking, leadership speaking.
Leadership, yes.
As I can see around, Barbara is not here. And it's a normal thing, because each time when we hear, or supposed to hear something interesting, she's absent. So, oh my God, where are my manners? I'm Dr. Szczerba. And I was studying with Barbara for 5 years at the Technical University at Gdańsk. So because she's absent, I will use her as an example. I will tell you a few stories and you will maybe have some lessons for the future. So, I think that Barbara was born with a big sign chemical experiment. The second thing what I think about Barbara, why she chose chemistry, is also that she loves colors. Like colorful ball pens and stickers. The first situation happened during biology classes, where we supposed to grow some colonies of fungus. And there is a fungus called Aspergillus nigger. And tell me, darling, what do you think nigger stays in Latin? What word?
Black.
Excellent. Eloquent audience. Yes. So it was the fungus that actually is black when you grow it in a specific container. But Barbara always used gloves, rubber gloves, and that time she had them also. But you cannot force the nature. She felt itching in her cheek, so she scratched it. And we had a great success as a group because we had a colony of fungus on Barbara's cheek. Amazing. Barbara is amazing, believe me. And the second thing was the chemistry classes where we're supposed to heat the chemical substance over the fire. And this is what we call the test tube. Because Barbara cares about safety, so she turned the open edge, not for the colleague next to her, but onto the ceiling. The idea of the task was, tell us what is the color of the final product, as fast as you can. So the question comes, what is the color of the final product, Barbara? Red. Okay. Barbara did her diploma from chemistry. Really. And there was the task also to measure a small amount of a liquid. Let me say that it is the glass straw. You know what straw is. Mm-hmm. You just straw. So if to measure the small amount of a liquid, you have to somehow take it off. There are special devices to do so. But all of them were broken. So what Barbara did? She turned back to the professor and just do it with her mouth. Not do it. Why is it so dangerous? Because you know what acetic acid is? You have it here, for example. But it's about, I don't know, a few percent. But Barbara worked with the acid of 70%. So my professor, probably he knew what I would do. He told me, Barbara, do not do it with your mouth. And I said, yes, of course. But everybody knew that I was lying because I had white lips. Okay, Barbara finished studies with a good grade, I must admit. But it doesn't mean that she stopped her chemical activity, which is not a good information for you. So a few years before, she mixed Domestos. We all know Domestos, for those of you who don't know. Domestos is used to clean the toilet, for bleaching, for disinfecting the toilet. And because Barbara is not reading instructions and any kind of labels, unless we are talking about drugs, she mixes it. If you mix it with some other chemical substances, for example, there is a reaction and you have a lot of this. It's a chloride, it's a very annoying gas. So she put it into the toilet and for a stronger effect, I left it for a few hours and went shopping. Not I, Barbara. Her parents came home and there was a fog. The fog consisted of chloride. Why am I saying it to you? There are four lessons you can take. The first one is never mess with your face if you are not sure that your hands are clean. The second one, safety comes first in any situation. The third one is do not swallow any kind of liquid of concentration you don't know. And the fourth one is do not try to be the perfect housewife at all costs. But what I bother the most, my dear Toastmasters, you spent with Barbara 2 hours per week. You don't know the time and the place when something interesting happens. So it will happen for sure because Barbara is around you. So be aware, Toastmasters.